This is
a 2024
Tesla Model Y, and in this video I'm just going to look at the build quality of these. So Tesla have quite a bad reputation for build quality, and often panel gaps are mentioned. But maybe that was justified back in 2012 when they launched the Tesla Model S. I've got a 2014 Model S myself, and yeah, the panel gaps aren't all equal and the trim along the top of the doors don't line up. But that vehicle's done 119,000 miles now and it's still rattle free, and it's running on all the original suspension components apart from the drop links on the anti-roll bar. But here we have a new Tesla Model Y. This is a 2024 model. This was built in the Shanghai factory, because in the UK all of our Model Ys and Model 3s come from Shanghai, because the Berlin factory are only making left-hand drive vehicles. And this was built in early November 2023, or maybe late October, and this arrived in the UK on the 5th of December 2023. So this car is now 4 days old. I've done 350 miles in it, and so far I'm very impressed with the quality of the vehicle. So let's have a little walk around and I'll just show you what the build quality is like now on a new Tesla. But there are a couple of little things I'm going to point out as well, which maybe aren't perfect, but overall I'm mighty impressed. So firstly, panel gaps. Looking down there, that is all absolutely perfect and in line. The door trims line up. The panel gap down there is all spot on. Again, the door trims line up there. That panel gap is spot on. As is all the back. I cannot see any issue at all. Some people say the lights aren't mounted correctly, but not so in this case. Maybe, yeah, there is a little bit of a bigger gap there than there is there. So not perfect, but pretty good. Again, trims all line up. That gap down there is all spot on. That all lines up. That gap down there is all equal as well. And so is that. Gap there is fine. The windscreen and the glass roof are all flush here. And it's the same on the other side as well. On a Tesla, the panel gaps tend to show up between the bonnet and the wing and the bumper, because it's all curved and there's three pieces they have to line up. But on this, it is all very good. Cannot fault it whatsoever. And the way the bumper fixes to the wing and the headlight is mounted, it is all flush, all equal, and absolutely perfect. So the exterior fit and finish of this vehicle, I think, is perfect. If I'm being super picky, there is just a slightly larger gap here between that rear light assembly and the hatch than on this side. And if I open it up, those lights do stay on the hatch, and this light assembly houses the charge port flap here. So the issue, I guess, is that light assembly could have been in by another 1.5 millimeters or so. And the other thing is that bumper has a little bit of flex at the top there, but the gap is fine, but there's a little bit of flex there, any deviation of a millimeter or so, and nothing on that side. But when it comes to the inside, it's very good. There is zero rattles. Haven't even found the seat belts rattling against this bit of plastic. That can be an issue. Same on many cars, to be honest, but haven't had any rattles at all in this car. And I found the fit and finish of everything inside, the center console, the screen, the dash, it's all been rattle-free. And cannot really fault it at all. So if I'm being really picky again, the only issue I found on the inside is this bit of trim along the door here, this metal bit in the middle. I don't know whether the camera's picking it up, but it almost looks like three fingerprints there. There are three little areas. I'm not sure whether it's even grease or, you know, finger marks, but it doesn't seem to rub off. But there is three bits there that are slightly discoloured. And the same goes for this bit of metal here on the trim on the dash, where it bends around that corner. There is a little indentation on it there, which is slightly different to the indentation on that side. And once you see these things, you can't unsee it. So from the driver's seat here, I can see a little indentation on the corner there, which is visible, but this is being super picky. And I expect if I raised it with Tesla, they would probably change the dash panel. But it isn't a fault. There isn't a dent there. It's where that metal is bent around, and I think it's just the shadows probably, so it's not a fault at all. But looking from this angle, it almost looks like an indentation. But if I look back at this bit of trim, from this angle, I cannot see that discoloration. But from the angle here, I can see it. But I'll put a bit of polish on there. Maybe that will polish out. But if I go round to the passenger side and look at the dash here, it is exactly the same. So it's not a manufacturing default. It's where the metal goes around the corner, and this metal does have a crease in the middle. So obviously the top half is at a slightly different angle to the bottom half when it comes round, and you get a little bit of a gap there because you can't bend that metal the same way as this top wooden profile. So yeah, it's perfectly normal. It's just when you're sat in the driver's seat looking down there, it looks like a dent, but it isn't. It's just the way the light falls on it. So this isn't a manufacturing default at all, but maybe this is. But it's so minor, I'm not even going to raise it as a ticket. I'm sure Tesla would change that if I complained, but it's not worth it. So the only other negative I can find with this vehicle externally is simply the way the number plates are mounted. And on these, you have a panel behind the number plate, which gives you that flat surface. And then you've got a plastic mounting frame, which is fixed to it. And it's quite simply, they've mounted the number plate off center. So on this side, you can see it's too far that way and it overhangs on this side. So that's not the factory has done that, because I suspect these are fitted by the guys in the UK. And when the ship comes in and they're delivering these vehicles, they're delivering hundreds per day. And they've just rushed and mounted that off center. So it's not a big problem. That's only two screws hold that on, and I'm going to be taking this frame away anyway and sticking the plate straight to that back mounting frame. So that's it. That's just the issue with the guy who was doing the initial PDI mounting the plates, but they got it spot on the back. So Tesla have really improved their build quality over the years, and in particular the Shanghai vehicles are really built to a high standard. And yeah, the comments about Tesla build quality no longer justified. It's a thing of the past, and these are built just as well as European vehicles. So that will do for this video. If you found it useful, please do click the thumbs up button. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel if you're not. And if you want to know more about the Model Y, I'll put a link in the video description below to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made on this vehicle. This is still new, so there aren't too many videos yet, but that list will be increasing over time. And if there's anything in particular you want to know about the Model Y, write in the comments. I'll do my best to answer all the questions and also make videos on what you want to see as well.